So one way of speeding up hit times is to overlap one hit with another, and we can achieve this, for example, through pipelining the cache. If the cache takes multiple cycles to access, we can have a situation where an access comes in cycle n and it's a hit. And now if another access comes in cycle n plus 1, and it would be a hit too, in a non-pipeline cache, the second access has to wait until the first access is done using the cache, and it takes multiple cycles to do that. So in this situation, the hit time, as seen by each access, is the actual hit time of a cache, plus the wait time that the access suffers because it cannot access the cache until the previous one is done. And in that situation, pipelining the cache so that we can send in accesses one after the other will improve the overall hit time. Now, it may sound straightforward how to pipeline the cache. You just divide it in, let's say, three stages. But how do you split what amounts to basically a read from a large array? Because that's really what the cache is. Remember that the cache access consists of using the index part of the address to find the set, reading out the tags and valid bits that correspond to the blocks in that set, comparing the tags and checking the valid bits for each of these to see whether it has a hit, combining these so that we know whether we have an overall hit and where in our set. Once we know where, we read out the data and use the offset to choose the right part of the large cache block, at which point we have the data that the processor wants and our cache access is done. So one example of a cache pipeline would be to have this part reading out the tags and so on from the cache array be stage one, determining the hits and beginning the data read would be stage two, and finishing the actual data read all the way to getting the data would be stage three. So as you can see, we can pipeline the cache access even if we don't know how to actually break down the reading from the cache array, especially if the tags and the valid bits are read before we determine the hit, and we only read the data part of the cache after we determine the hit. In that case, just those two can be separate stages. Usually, the actual cache hit time for level one caches will be one, two, or three cycles. One cycle caches don't need pipelining, and two and three cycle caches can be relatively easily pipelined into two or three stages. So usually, level one caches will be pipelined